Subaru is the number one brand for battery problems. I know guys who buy a new battery at least once a year for their Outbacks and Foresters, and it's ridiculous that dealerships just say, it's okay, keep doing that. Well, Subaru has been through a lot of problems because of the battery issues. They even had to fight against a class action lawsuit with an extended warranty and some crappy software updates that barely help anyone solve this problem. And even after the updates, Subaru cars keep killing 12-volt batteries much faster than other vehicles. You need to understand that the quick death of the 12-volt battery in these cars happens because of basically two main reasons: parasitic drains through a faulty module and undercharging the battery. Speaking about the parasitic drain, there is actually one very common problem, and it's the DCM module or data communication module, which is the system supporting Subaru Starlink and the SOS button. After tons of TSBs and software updates, it's still killing the batteries in Subaru cars, and there is a brutal solution. People tend to take out the fuse that covers the DCM module, and it kills your SOS functions, Starlink equipment, but keeps the battery running much longer. I can confirm that your car will easily go through safety inspections in every state and country if your SOS button doesn't work, but you can always put that fuse back before the inspection. Anyway, you need to understand that the emergency calls through the SOS function will not be possible. So this somehow compromises safety in your vehicle. The second big problem is that Subaru programs its alternators to keep the battery just slightly charged at all times, so it's never charged completely. You may notice that soon after you start the car, the voltage in the system drops to 13 volts, and this level is not enough to charge the battery at all. This is a tricky logic of the car software to reduce the load to the engine and save a couple of drops of fuel. Actually, the initial goal is to reduce the emissions by a tiny bit, but I fairly doubt that throwing away two lead acid batteries a year is going to be better for the environment than burning one additional gallon of fuel in the entire lifespan of the car. Anyway, you may try to argue with your dealership and make them update the software of your vehicle so that it charges the battery properly, but I assure you that even if they find such an update, it will not fix the things. So the only good fix that you may eventually control is buying a good external battery charger and charging your battery fully once every 3 or 4 months. Just make sure that you're using an AGM charger if you have the AGM type of battery installed. This will take your battery to at least 5 or 6 years, and you won't need to freak out when the battery is suddenly low and the car throws a ton of unrelated and random warning lights and messages.